Guys at MDTV, it's Dave Mad Max 6. We're at Gold's Venice on a beautiful Sunday. And then I met, we're going to introduce you guys to a new IFBB pro, women's physique, Danielle Mastro Mateo, who just won the Junior USA. Danielle, how are you?
I'm good, Dave. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks for meeting us today. And congratulations on your pro card. And
Thank you. And you
must be really excited, really happy.
Yeah, very excited.
Things are happening fast for you. So we're actually waiting for her trainer, Abbas Katami, who's also an IFBB pro. It's a little late, so I'm going to give him a little flack on camera. But we're going to get a little bit of workout. We're going to get to meet Danielle. She's going to tell us about, you know, winning the Cal last year to her pro card this year and jumping right into the IFBB women's physique and just competed in Denver. So she's got a lot going on. She's young. She's pretty. And she's... yeah, don't be shy. So we're going to get to meet her a little bit. So come, let's just... Where's your bag? Is this your bag?
Okay. Okay.
It's so nice today, huh?
Yeah, it's
beautiful.
So nice out, having good weather.
So Danielle, you actually drove all the way from Orange County to come and meet us in Goals today.
I did. Yeah, I mean, it's not that far. It's less than an hour, but I never come up here.
Yeah, and especially on the weekend. On the Sunday, there's no traffic, so that's great.
Yeah, right? It wasn't too bad.
Yeah. So Danielle, as Abbas is making his way over here, I want to talk to you a little bit about how long has it been since you started competing? You won the Cal last year. And then got your pro card this year, which is very fast. So how long have you been in this game?
It did happen very fast. When I did the Cal last year, that was my first time competing in physique. I had competed once before 3 years earlier. I did figure and I didn't place and I didn't have as much muscle as I thought I did at the time. So I didn't want to compete anymore then. And so I just, for the next 2 years, I just kept training and I was getting bigger and bigger. And then I met Abbas, and when I started to prep for a show, I didn't even know that I was big enough to do physique. Then I hadn't leaned out in a long time. And then, so it was really a big surprise for me last year to win the Cal, my first time doing
it. It's a big show. A Cal is not easy to win the Cal. It was
exciting. But then I didn't feel like I was ready to go to the national level then. I mean, having only competed once. And so I took the rest of the year. I just trained and I added a couple more pounds of muscle this year and then did Junior USA's.
It's nice. I mean, on Facebook, of course, you can follow everybody's progress. So I saw your picture from the Cal compared to the Junior USA. It was good progress in 1 year, very, very good progress. And then right away, as soon as you got your card at Junior USA, you came back and decided, I'm going to get my feet wet and just go compete in Denver right away.
Yeah, that was something we had talked about as sort of like a, what if you win in South Carolina? What are we going to do? And so we had talked about it, but it was a big what if. And so when we got to Denver and checked into the hotel, I was like, Abbas, we're in Denver. Like, the crazy plan really happened. So it was so exciting to go into a pro show right away. And that way there was really no anxiety for me about making my pro debut. Because
right.
It just happened before
get it
I
over
could
with.
Even think about
get it. Get over
it.
With. Get your feet well. Are you glad you did that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Glad I did it. Because now I can take a break. Now I've kind of seen how I stack up compared to the pros. And I know what I want to improve. So... now I can rest a little bit and work on that.
I think you're right. Sometimes people, when they get their pro card, they're like, okay, I gotta wait to see if I'm competitive. And sometimes the longer you wait, the more nervous it makes you, I'm sure.
Yeah,
right.
That's what I was worried about.
Wow, that's great. So how did you and Abbas actually meet each other?
We had a mutual friend for a couple years, and he always told me, Danielle, whenever you want to get back in shape, or not that I was out of shape, but whenever I wanted to do a show, he said, you gotta work with this guy, Abbas. You gotta work with Abbas. And I never knew who he was. And then one day I just saw him in the gym and I wasn't sure if it was him, but I thought maybe it could be. And then I looked him up on Facebook and then I wanted to do a show and I finally messaged him on Facebook one day. And
gotta love Facebook.
Yeah.
Right. That's awesome. All right. Well, thanks for talking to us. We're going to, Abbas is going to come here in a minute. He's also getting ready for a show as well. So
yeah, must Chicago
be...
Pro.
Wow. Oh, so he's really close. Like we're what, 3 weeks out?
I think 4 weeks.
Yeah. Wow.
I think it's 4th July weekend.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
all right. So we're gonna wait for him a little bit and then we're going to talk to him, do some training a little bit, maybe go eat. We'll see what's going on this beautiful Sunday in Gold's Venice. All right. Thanks, Danielle.
Good to see you.
How are you? Everything good?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I haven't seen you all week.
So Abbas, you got a show coming up, man.
Yeah, I got the Chicago Pro.
How many weeks?
4 weeks now.
4 weeks?
And then after that, I'll be doing Sacramento, and then Tampa, and then that's it.
You're busy, man. We never hear from you. That's what happens with the Orange County boys, man. We never see your mug up here. And...
No. Life, you get caught up in life when you get older, man.
Yeah.
You know, when you're a youngster, you know, you can get in, you know, bodybuilding, do whatever the hell you want to do. You have no bills, you have nothing to take care of, you just eat.
That's the life, yeah.
And that's it. So you get older.
That's right. All right. Well, you came today, man. We appreciate you guys both coming in. And we were talking with Danielle a bit earlier, and she was telling us, you know, you guys been training for a few years and how you helped her with her back and all that stuff. You guys always train back on Sunday. And so she's really excited, man. She's, you know, she's doing great. And, you know, a big part of you, I'm sure, is because of your help. So how long, how many years you guys been together? Training?
It's been like a year and a half.
A year and a half.
She came to me about 6 months before the Cal.
All right, that's
so
right.
So we, you know, kind of like changed her training because she was training heavy. She's a beast. She's strong as hell. And I was like, all right, we got to like change this training, you know, the way you're doing, because we got to bring your legs down,
yeah,
bring your upper body up a little bit. You know, she hated it for a long time. She probably still does hate it, but, but you know, you got to do what you got to do to transform the body a certain way. So,
right.
We did, and we did. I told her, I said, you know, if you listen, you're gonna win the Cal. I said, I know it, because once I saw her like open up and, you know, pose and stuff like that, I can envision what's gonna happen down the road. You know?
Yeah.
So, and I know like kind of like the scene and who the other girls are, this and that. So I just knew, and, you know, she just kind of said, okay, you know, and.
She listened. She was good enough to listen.
She didn't believe it was going to happen.
I did.
So, you know, as you know, time progressed and it was time to dive for the show, and slowly things started changing. And God, it was like 3 or 4 weeks out. She's doing some weird delts, and she was so fucking ripped. I mean, sorry about my language, but like her Christmas tree, like, it looked like abs.
Wow.
Out in their lower back. You
wow.
know? So I videotaped it. I have it somewhere on my Facebook. So, you know, I was getting excited because, you know, I won the Cal when I was 25.
Yeah.
She won it when she was 24. So for me, it was kind of special in a way because she went up there and I told her, I said, as soon as you turn to the front, open up, I want it done. Okay?
Yeah.
You walk out, turn to the front with her shoulder to waist ratio, it's going to be done.
Yeah.
And that's what happened.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not trying to be cocky but or arrogant by no means, but, you know, I've been in the sport for 20 years.
Yeah.
And I can tell I have the eye, you know.
Yeah.
I just knew what was going to happen. She wasn't hard, but, you know, that just comes with age. You know?
Right.
She's young.
Maturity.
She has still a little bit of baby fat, you know, on the legs, you know. But, you know, it doesn't matter because, you know, physique, they don't want them super shredded anyway.
That's right.
But we're still working on the little glute to hamstring tie-in, and from the Junior USAs, just within a week's time, we brought in a little bit more, and so we got, I don't know, we're going to take another year off, and then probably hit a couple shows back-to-back, and have her try to qualify for the Olympia.
I think that was, I was telling her that, I think it was great for her to actually just, good decision from you guys to actually have her compete right away, just see where she places, and how she fares with the pros, and that was great. Now the jitters are gone, and then, you know, can get ready for the next one, so. That's awesome.
It was good. I mean,
you must be really proud.
Oh, very proud. I mean, I was elated. You know? I mean, even for the Cal, because, like I said, I won it when I was young. I had no help. I had, you know, somebody helping
it's
me.
It's a lot tougher without
and,
help.
You know, so for me to help her, and, you know, and she didn't believe in herself, and I just, you have to always believe that you're going to get number one.
Right.
No matter what.
Right.
You know? Even if you get top five and you train your ass off, but at least you know you did your best.
That's right.
You know?
No regret.
So then I said, you know, listen, if you win this juniors, you're going to Denver. Okay.
I told him that.
And she already had a ticket, I don't know, to go, you know, I don't know, whatever. You know, a ticket that she had bought for something else, so she had credit.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so.
Nice.
We got, you know, interviewed, I think, by Dave Palumbo
backstage.
Yeah. So he's like, what are you going to do next? I said, I'm going to ask you to, you know, Denver.
Like, are you kidding me? Can we do that?
Yeah, you know, I said, you got to get your paperwork together and we're going right away. It doesn't matter where you place. You know, you just go get your feet wet. You're there. You know, it's only a couple more days of training, you know, and one more time of depleting, and that's it. You're done.
Yeah.
One more week. Suck it up.
Yeah.
So she did. And
seventh place is great.
23, 24.
That's awesome.
Goals. It was very good.
It's funny because we were just chatting a little bit earlier. She was talking about school and math and all that stuff. And this guy was very, he said, oh, you Danielle. I was just about to tell her, you know, there's a buzz about you. A lot of people are talking about you right now. And this guy said, oh, you Danielle. Oh, you just got your pro card. That was great. So
I told her, I said, I told her for the Cal, if you listen, this is what's going to happen. And I told her this year, I said, if you listen, I can get you to the Olympia by next year. And I'm not trying to be cocky with her genetics.
Right.
And me pushing her a certain way, I know what I can do to her body. You know?
Yeah.
And also on top of that, I did a video on Facebook being safe with the women. There's a lot of women, there's a lot of guys and all these so-called gurus. You know, there is good gurus there. Mm-hmm. But some of them, these people, they don't know what the hell they're doing. Mm-hmm. And they're really screwing with the girls' bodies. And, you know, women's bodies are very... a lot more delicate than guys.
You know,
you got to be more safe with them.
You're right.
Otherwise, you really just screw them up for the rest of their life.
That's right.
You know, so I wanted to take some time off, relax, and, you know, go back to school, finish, do whatever she's got
to
do.
Yeah, she
but
goes to school
time,
too. Yeah.
Train, you know, have a balanced life because she's young still.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Next year, if I have her in the Olympia, there's no girl at 26 going to be in the Olympia.
Wow.
Ever.
Wow.
You know, for
there's
physique.
There's a couple other young girls doing really well in physique right now.
No, really well in physique, but not being in the Olympia at 26.
Right, right.
So, I have high expectations.
But that's great, though. I think you guys are a good team. I think it's great. I hope the best for you guys. We're gonna go back. We're gonna go in there. Are you training with her, or are you just training her right now? You gonna stick with?
Whatever you want. I don't know what we're doing today.
I gotta train back today. It's Sunday.
All right, we're gonna follow you guys. Wrist training again. This is like the real deal coming back to life again.
Baby step.
There you go. All right, some back training.
All right.
Following you guys.
After the pro, the new pro.
Right. When you got Cormier telling you, you're doing good, that's a good compliment.
Looking at me a few years ago, I wasn't even in shape, so.
You know, he remembers now.
Wait, do I want to do what?
What is she doing today? That's a little bit.
We're heading back today. Usually Sunday she comes and hits back with me. For the Cal last year, we did like 3 days a week. We did a lot of legs because I wanted to bring her legs in more. But she got the gist of what I wanted her to do, so she was on her own doing that this year. This year we still wanted to bring more back thickness. So for what we're doing now, we're doing pull downs to get the width. Then we're getting the machine row here, elbows up high to get the mid rhomboids.
Okay.
And then we'll pick two other exercises after this. We'll do like a seated cable row with a rope rows.
Okay.
Hits two different areas of the lats again. And then last, we'll hit two other exercises, like either a reverse grip pull down with maybe an under grip, you know, row, barbell
gotcha.
Row to hit the lower lats.
Okay.
So we hit all areas of the back, but a lot of supersets just to bring in more detail.
Yeah.
But at the same time, bring in the thickness and overall back.
She was saying a little bit earlier that, you know, a common friend of yours actually told her, if you see you have someone help you, you gotta have Abbas. And then she saw you at Metrics and she said, oh, she can only see he's a huge back in a sweatshirt in the gym. She said, that's the guy to help me, that's the guy I need for the back.
She saw me the first time I was 270, so.
Wow.
And then, I don't know, then she emailed me out of the blue and she said, well, I got this race to do, I'm gonna run a race. And I'm like, okay.
I was running half marathons.
She was running half marathons.
I was like, after my next race, I'll start.
Yeah. So at that point, I was like, okay, we'll see if this girl's serious.
Yeah.
You know, and then she came and,
you know,
it took a little while for her to get used to my training style, but
there's an adjustment period.
Things clicked and that's it.
That's good.
All right, this is going to be our first, last set here.
All right.
Talk about
beast.
Yeah. Plus robocalls.
Yeah.
the upper middle right here. That's what we're focusing on in this exercise. Come on, squeeze. Let's go. Pull. You get in some drop sets as well. If you don't get enough reps, you keep going. Drop the weight, keep it up. Come on, go. Oh, let's go.
those sets of 20, they get out of you. That's a lot. It's a lot of reps.
Back always makes me tired. I don't know, like pulling.
Back and legs are the two toughest body parts. Yeah. Yeah.
What happens when you diet? You gotta carry your shit around too.
Your food.
No undergrip hammer strength one.
Oh boy.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
The one that's just a straight pull down. I don't think so.
Yeah.
Alright, this is the last set of supersets we're gonna do. Usually sometimes we'll pick one or more exercises by itself. But we're hitting the lower lats. Because if we get upper lats, I wanted to bring out the suit from the lower, so we'll hit like an undergrip pull down, or if we have like an undergrip hammer. So since we don't have an undergrip hammer today, we'll just do the undergrip pull downs.
Okay.
Superset it with a reverse grip row. Another one, more. Let's go.
Nice. How was that?
Good. What's next?
One more. So usually what we do is we do a minute and a half resting between the supersets. So we did three with the first round, three with the second round, three with this round, and then what we'll usually do is just one isolation by itself.
Gotcha.
So either like a one-arm cable, you know, or dumbbell rows.
Right.
Dumbbell rows, single arm. So we'll hit that today, and then
good.
That finishes up back.
Nice. She's still in shape. You went back right to the diet, Danielle? You
didn't... Yeah.
No?
Yeah, you're right. No, this week I've been taking a break. I was hungry all year. I'm not hungry anymore. I'm full now.
She's full and happy. This is the happiest I've seen her in maybe like 3 months.
Really?
Yeah, probably.
Food, huh? Food makes you happy.
Last week was quiet. There was no talking.
I don't talk much. I don't talk much.
So we caught you at a good time then.
And on top of that, I was dieting, so I didn't talk too much. So I told her, I'm like, listen, I'm sorry, but I'm not talking that much. I'm just exhausted.
Yeah.
It was 2 weekends in a row, you know.
Yep.
We were just on the airplane next to each other, not talking.
Yeah, so we finally got a chance to sit down and talk on the airplane, and then that was it. And then back to the gym on Monday when
yep.
we got back.
Yep.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, train.
We went to the gym Sunday night when we got back from South Carolina.
Oh, yeah.
I was still, like, so tan.
She did cardio, I had to train, so...
Did you do any photo shoot, Danielle? Anything after the show?
In South Carolina, yeah.
Okay, with who did you... Yeah?
Dan Ray.
Nice.
Dan a couple times.
Very nice.
But in Denver, no, we just rested up.
Good. Nice.
All right, on the dumbbell rows.
All right.
More height.
Nice.
I think I'll do like one more and call it a day.
Busy Sunday.
Yeah.
Productive Sunday. I want to say thanks a lot for coming on Sunday at Goals and then Abbas. Congratulations on Danielle's success. Danielle, you look great. We're looking forward to see you guys in the future. Abbas, you're competing in just about 4 weeks, so we're going to do something with you also. You get like three in a row, you're telling me, right?
Chicago, then the Sacramento Ani show, and then Tim Gardner's, both Tim Gardner shows, Chicago and the Tampa Pro.
Wow, it's all or nothing for you, huh? Either we don't see you at all, or you're doing them all.
So, life happens, so
yeah.
I have to take care of shit in my life. And,
yeah.
And now, I got my brand, the Persian Muscle, got the website coming up, I got the clothing for men and women. And,
nice.
I just want to build my brand up, build my name back up. My ultimate goal getting into the sport was going into Olympia and being on the Arnold stage. I don't care where I place. I just want that was my goal.
Nice.
So I'm healthy, I'm strong, I feel good, and it's my time now.
All right. You're telling me you have a little private place also in Orange County and stuff. Maybe we'll see that eventually on the footage and stuff. But
maybe we can train there.
That'd be good. You know, Danielle, you train there as well too. So. Very cool. Well, thanks for coming all the way to Venice, you guys. And then best of luck in the future.
Yeah.
I'm sure we'll see you guys again very, very soon. Right.
Definitely see you. Thanks for having us today.
Thank you.
MD, thank you. And we'll be back up on this.
That's right. Thanks, you guys.